Ik heb geleerd dat de leven is te kort en we moeten amuseren van de leven.
We failed in economic, yes, but we have proud in our culture. We are very proud people.
You can just call the trees by dialing this number. Whoa.
That's amazing.
Welkom bij de vijfde aflevering van Fans of Flanders seizoen 4. Op de plank deze week een temperamentvolle begrafenisondernemer uit Colombia, een rondleiding in de crib van een Portugese expat, een herfstwandeling in een magisch klankenbos en de blind date van IJslander Björn. Speciaal voor expats, maar ook voor jullie, gelukzakken van bij ons. De asielcrisis is nog lang niet achter de rug, maar nieuwspotter Nigel zoekt mee naar oplossingen.
The Belgian Minister of Migration, Theo Franken, has said that refugees who want to come and live in Belgium should sign a declaration saying that they accept the moral and democratic values of Europe. And I agree with him. Values such as 90% of all wealth should be in the hands of 1% of the population. Values like, we support only democratic regimes in other countries, unless they have oil. Values as, you have to put all your money in a bank, and that bank can then invest that money in the war in your country, which made you came here in the first place. It all boils down to, everything's for sale, even our values. Cheers.
Aangezien het allerheilige was, ging Fans of Flanders langs bij een expat die dagelijks met de dood wordt geconfronteerd.
Ik heb veel begrafenis gedaan hier. Voor mijn schouders en veel lichaam meegebracht.
Ismael is een begrafenisondernemer uit Colombia. En dat is geen evidente keuze voor iemand met een zuiders temperament.
Ik werk al 9 jaar in de begrafenissector. In de bureau doe ik de printjes voor de overledens. Kisten. Ik ga naar de rusthuis voor de lichaam te halen. En dan voorbereiden van de begrafenis van de dienst. Het is een speciaal job. Dat is niet voor iedereen. Je moet dat grote hart hebben voor dit te doen. Het verschil tussen de begrafenis hier in België en in Colombia is heel groot. In Colombia de mensen huilen. Je komt binnen met de overlijden en dan aan de ingang van de kerkhof je vindt meisjes, 4, 5, 7 meisjes. Je zegt oké, huilen voor David. En je betaalt 2 euro en ze huilen. Oh, David, waarom? Zo, is anders. Huh? De mensen hier in België zijn meer gereserveerd. Ze huilen maar zo van binnen. Je ziet niet totaal anders. In Colombia we roepen. Waarom? Ik woon graag in België. Hier is een rustig land. Als ik vergelijk met mijn stad, Cartagena. Ik word zot daar. Te veel feestjes, te veel parties, altijd. Dit is Cartagena, de stad waar ik geboren ben. Feestjes, elke dag. De muziek, de strand. In de weekend werk ik in de bar, Colombiaanse bar. Ik vind het leuk in de bar aan werken, want ik breng terug mijn gevoelen toen ik in Colombia was. S'avondsfeestjes, s'morgen begrafenis. Disfruten de la vida, que es una sola. Ik heb geleerd dat de leven is te kort en we moeten amuseren van de leven.
Tijd voor een Vlaamse update.
I was reading in the newspaper the other day that the Belgian police aren't happy because their uniforms don't match. The hats are different to the coats are different to the trousers, and the uniforms are never the same in any other city. We don't know who a policeman is anymore. The other day, I thought I was being arrested, but it turned out it was just a postman. I mean, the word says it itself. Uniform, uniform. The uniforms should be all the same everywhere. Get your act together, police. I guess I'd rather stay with somebody else. Yes, my brain driving, getting lost at all. See him, I take you away. That is, so love is die alone. Here's all the time I
Wablief van deze week legt Chrisje weer een prachtige Vlaamse uitdrukking uit. Volle bak.
Hello and a very warm welcome to our long-standing item in which we find true delight in introducing you to the many wonders of the Flemish language. This week we opted for two words that make the well-known expression volle bak. Now, vol easily translates as full, but a bak is another thing. It could be a bin or a crate, a big car or even jail. Now, when you're saying it is volle bak somewhere, you are really saying there's a full house. It could be volle bak in the supermarket or on the dance floor. It could be volle bak at the courthouse. And every Sunday on Canvas, it is volle bak, thanks to this show. Now, you could also do something volle bak, and that's when you do it with gusto or without limits. You can turn the radio volle bak, meaning you crank it up until the volume reaches dangerous levels. It can rain volle bak in Belgium, as you know, and you can have volle bak fun on our highways. Ha! So if you want to live your life to the max, live it volle bak.
In Expat Cribs geven expats ons een rondleiding in hun huis. Deze week bezoeken we Sarah, een Portugese schone met een hart voor voetbal en heel lieve buren.
Hello everyone, I'm Sarah, I'm from Portugal and you are very good welcome here in my house. Here there's sometimes a big rivalry, how you say it, yes, between two greatest football clubs in Portugal. So, what happens? My boyfriend goes for Benfica. Sometimes he's doing the garden, you know, in the grass, cutting the grass with this on. I really don't like that very much. I never go for Benfica, I always go for Sporting. So this is the real good club in Portugal. We don't have Portuguese television here at home, but we watch the games on the internet, yes, all the time. His name is Zeca. This one is Zeca with Simba. Chico. This one is also Simba. He passed away. Yes, I'm crazy about cats, and they are not just cats. They are part of the family. They are like my babies, my brothers, my everything. I lived with my parents in Portugal, so they stay there. It's like a small way to have a cat here with me. Yeah, so yes, all small things that keeps me with animals near. Let's go to check the garden. Sorry for the grass, no time to cut the grass, but okay, it's not so obsessive cut it like Belgians like. We have tomatoes, kerstomaten, strawberries. Well, here it's very difficult to have vegetables outside, so we have to have one thing like this. It's in our blood a little bit, so we need to feel the contact with that, yeah, the earth and the vegetables. It's very nice for us. Hey! I was really lucky. I have really wonderful neighbors here, and they offer themselves to hang our Portuguese flag. If I see my flag here, it's like, okay, I'm very proud, very, very proud of being Portuguese. We failed in economic, yes, but we have proud in our culture. We are very proud people. Fans of Flanders, it's time to say goodbye. I hope you enjoyed the visit. Hope to see you soon next time. Okay, bye-bye.
Afgelopen week was er heel wat commotie over de Vlaamse bossen. Fans of Flanders kon niet achterblijven en trok naar Klankenbos in Neerpelt. Een uniek en volledig gratis openluchtmuseum dat als muziek in de oren klinkt.
My name is David. I'm 13 years old. I'm born in Madrid and I'm Swedish and Spanish.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Jill.
I'm David.
Hi.
Hallo.
I'm Jill.
Ik ben Christine.
Welkom in Klankenbos.
Thank you.
We are now in a piece of sound art. The sounds you can hear now in the music comes directly out of the woods. You can hear that the sound is produced through the woods. So that's a very special manner of listening to music, listening to sounds. And I think that's exactly the thing we want to do with Klankenbos. We're now in the beautiful Klankenbos. And the unique thing about it is that all pieces of art here have to do with sounds or with silence. So which sounds do we hear, for example, now?
Well, I hear wind, the leaves moving, and some birds chirping.
We're now in front of maybe something that looks like a strange construction of wooden boxes, but it's in fact a musical instrument. And you will see that the boxes will come to live.
So how does it work?
It works with an engine. The boxes below, they start to shiver, start to shake, and the other ones just follow, very like chaos.
Yeah.
So what we see here is in fact a huge bass flute. If you go inside, and we will do it now, and if you go to the other side of the flute will start to make a very low sound, a very low frequency. The installations are very visual, also very physical. They work with sound, which is a medium that everyone can feel with his body or with his ears. So it's really a collection that attracts and children and adults, older people, so everyone. This is a sound installation that doesn't make sound. This is real silence.
Yeah.
And we're not used to it anymore. Because in our cities, there's everywhere noise. I don't know who has a smartphone of you.
Oh, I have one right here.
Fantastic. You can just call the trees by dialing this number. Whoa.
That's amazing.
It was amazing today. What do you think, Christina?
It was very nice.
You're supposed to always stay awake, always stay alert for the beautiful sounds in the forest.
er sinds kort een nieuwe expat bij. Björn uit IJsland. Wekelijks schrijft hij brieven naar huis over zijn avonturen in onze kleine regio. Een exclusieve kijk op de correspondentie naar zijn papa.
Dear papi, how is mama? I wish I had someone special in my life, just like you. Someone to keep me warm at night and to support me when I feel down. A beautiful girl with a nice hair and a soft skin.
What is this? It's kind of light. Oh, my body starts to shiver.
To find the love of my life, I tried to play a typical Icelandic seducing game. A fish for a kiss. But the Belgian women play hard to get. I decided to have a makeover.
Yes, you're lovely, with your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you.
I was ready for my final shot, a blind date. My blind date was slightly older than I expected. But in Iceland, we respect the elderly. I wanted to use the toilet, but I took the wrong turn. Oh, puppy. Dating in Flanders is really weird. I'll never have a blind date again. Stort knus, Björn.
Now, today we associate an owl with wisdom, but in the Middle Ages, an owl symbolized human stupidity.